Now, school administrators across the country have been sternly warned against any exam malpractice ahead of the 2020 Uganda Advanced Certificate of Examination that are due to be held very soon. The caution was sounded by the Minister for ICT and National Guidance, Honorable Judith Nabakova.
Minister Judith Nabakova has cautioned schools against malpractice as Senior 6 get into their final 2020 examinations. The minister says tougher penalties have been set and schools that will be caught cheating examinations will be dealt with. The minister was speaking this morning during a media briefing here in Kampala.
Special warning from UNEB. This year's exams are being conducted under the new UNEB Act that was recently gazetted. This time, all those who neglect their duty in reporting or preventing malpractices will also be arrested and charged in the courts of law. Punishment for offences under the exam malpractices have been increased from 6 months to 5 years. All payment of a fine of 5 million Ugandan shillings, all both.
The minister also commended the team that is in the lead in the fight against COVID-19 vaccination, saying government has now reduced the years for those to be vaccinated from 70 to 50 years.
About 144,025 people had so far been vaccinated as of the 8th April. The Minister of Health has also increased the bracket of those eligible for the vaccination. Previously, it was senior citizens who are 70 years and above. This has now been brought down to 50 years and above. Also, all individuals between 18 and 50 years with underlying conditions such as hypertension, diabetes, liver, heart, all kidney issues are now eligible for the vaccination. I therefore want to remind all those in the above categories to report to the nearest health centers.
Meanwhile, today morning, districts that make up Ankole region received UNEB exams accompanied by heavy military deployment.
We received USCE examinations from the Uganda National Examinations Board, and we expect to begin our examinations tomorrow on the 12th of April 2021. So far, everything is going on well. The examinations have been accompanied by strong security.
Surprisingly, though exams were offloaded at RIS Region Police Headquarters, you could hardly see any police officer, but instead UPDF was in charge.
This, I think 2 years ago or 3 years ago, examination security has improved. Previously, we used to have only our local policemen, but this time, because of the experience and what has been happening, the government and UNEB decided to deploy, at least to work hand in hand with most of the security operatives. We have the military police, we have the local police, and we have even some other security agencies, security personnel, non-uniform.
In an interview with the 2nd Division spokesperson, he said that both uniform and non-uniform men are to closely monitor the whole process.
Of course, cheating is a criminal. It is a criminal. It's against the laws of Uganda. And that's really a very, very, very bad culture. We believe if the students finish the syllabus, they are going to pass. And we are sure these are common questions they have been answering from senior one up to senior four. Therefore, when they are implementing a government policy, different stakeholders have different roles to play. For example, UNEB is doing its part. For us, as security operatives, we are also doing our part.
On the other hand, Uganda National Examination Board appeals to all schools to adhere to designed seating guidelines.
Organizing our halls where we are going to write our examinations for, we have tried our level best to follow the Minister of Education and Sports and the Minister of Health guidelines, the standard operating procedures. Obviously, we have increased the distance from one student to another, so we don't have any problem. And we have also agreed with our colleagues that we put a hand washing facility on every entry.
UNEB anticipates a total number of 980,379 Senior 6 candidates. to sit for final examinations. Mbara alone has 32 centers. Story by Halson Kagure and Ismail.